Okay, guys, next topic I'm going to show you. See if any, okay, see in order to communicate with any external databases, how to do the process we'll understand today. See, for this, no need to install any database in the real time. Actually, any external databases connection or communication, first two steps in the real time, it will be done by some lead team or some separate team will be there. They are going to configure, but without having any database installed in our application or in our system. So we can communicate with some external databases and how to do that. So we are going to understand now with one example. So the example we are going to work out is, so apart from internal database, how to communicate or how to connect with any external database setup given to you in the real time. Okay. And in order to do this setup, first two steps I need to configure in the rule base. So if any one unable to open the rule base, so they cannot do this example. So just to follow the steps, suppose if any system, if you have problem configuring this rule base connection, you cannot do this setup. Okay, so they can just follow the document or video. Okay, so if you have already this rule base connection is already successfully created, means so they can do the first two steps inside the rule base. So that is, we need to create a physical database and add the privileges. And second step is physical table we need to define and add the required privileges. So first two steps we are going to do it in the rule base. But in the real time it will be done for you by separate team will be doing for this. Okay. Now open the rule base. So totally seven steps we need to configure in order to communicate with any external databases. First two steps we are going to add in the rule base, and remaining five steps we are going to do in the Pega platform. Under PRPC we are going to configure. So first open this rule base window. Click on pgadmin 4. So expand this. Double click on localhost if you get a no connection. So expand these databases. See, in my system already I'm having one database. Okay, don't worry. So suppose in your system what you need to do means, see, under the databases I'm having one internal database and external database is there. Now we are going to create one more external database connection. Okay, but here external database connection, the thing is, it will take the on top of the it will take the same some information and all it will take from the internal database, but in the real time maybe one or two configuration can be different. Okay, the name can be different in the real time, but procedure is similar only. Okay, so in order to create an external database connection and its privileges, let's see. So right click on databases, create database. So right click on databases and click on create database. See, here I'm giving some name in the, if you want to in your system you can give any name, but give it in lower case. What are the names I'm going to give? So give it in lower case. I'm giving something like ABCDB, and after giving the name go to security tab. Some privileges we must define. See, here the thing is, again the owner here we are going to use the PEG PostgreSQL only as a main thing, but in the real time the owner can be different. Okay, see here the database which you are going to add, so the owner we are taking as PostgreSQL because only this we can configure, but in the real time it can be like SQL or DB2, IBM DB2 or any other MySQL or any other they can use. Okay, but PostgreSQL is common. Only thing is the owner name can be different in the real time. Okay. And after that, so go to security. Some privileges we have to configure. Click on add option. Then below the grantee column, select public. Then under the privileges column, click on the privileges column. So you'll be getting some checkboxes. Click on select all option and click outside. When you select all, some privileges will be created. So privileges means nothing but on this database, what kind of action we can perform, those are privileges. Like what are the different actions we can perform on this database. Then after the privileges are configured, so just click on save button. So this database connection will be created. Now expand the database and you can see, So if it is showing as no connection, double click on that. So when you double click on that, now go to the path which I'm showing. So go to schemas, expand public, and here you can see tables. So actually now under this I'm going to create one physical table. So first step is completed. So which I created this physical database connection and added the required privileges. Now add the step number 2. So add a physical table with column names and add the required privileges. And when you're adding a table, compulsory some key we have to set. And here external table will be calling as primary key. Okay. Some 2 to 3 fields I'll define. So right click on table and click on this option, create table. So I'm giving some name as so customer table, go to columns. So here you can add the define the column names. So data type is text is the data type. Okay, then add 2 more columns. Like that in the real time, what are the columns required, they can configure them. I'm adding 1 more. And here in the first column, you can select the key as S, you can select, and because I want to set customer read as a primary key. So select the button as S. Now after adding columns and setting the key, so we need to add privileges for this table. So if you go to security, okay, click on add privileges, and here grantee select, choose public. And in the privileges we have in this table, on this table, what kind of action we can perform, we can select all, insert, select, update, delete, truncate, triggers. So all actions you can perform on this, select all. So click on save button. Now after adding these records, sorry, after adding the table, I can assign some records. So for testing purpose, I'm going to manually enter the records here, whether the records are loading to the Pega application or not, how to configure those records to the Pega application. For testing purpose, I'm adding some records. So for this, go to view data. See, right click on the table name after creation. So view data, view all rows. So add some test records in this table. Some 2 to 3 records I'm going to assign. So double click on each column. So click on save button, like that, add 2 more records. Okay, just some records are given. Okay, now this setup in the first 2 steps will be adding in this rule base. Now again go back to Pega PRPC. Now the remaining steps you need to configure in the PRPC platform. So third step is we need to create from Pega PRPC to the rule base table. So database connection we have to create, not table first. First to create a database connection from the Pega PRPC platform. See, for the Pega contains one rule called sysadmin rule database is there. So we need to define that. So go to sysadmin category. The step number 3 is, so create a physical connection between Pega and the database. Okay. So make connection between PRPC and the database by using a rule called database rule. So it's a sysadmin rule. Go to sysadmin category and select this option database. And how to create this connection means you'll be using something called JDBC URL. Okay, you can give any name here, but in the external table, whatever the name I have given, I'm using the same ABCDB I'm using. But if you want to give any name, you can give, no issue. Okay, how the connection will be means, see, there are 3 to 4 options will be there, but mostly we'll be using JDBC URL connection. See, JDBC URL we have to choose in this process. See, what is this JDBC URL and how the format will be there means, so if you don't know that, actually in the server level, in your system where this PEGA is installed, go to PRPC personal edition. So here go to Tomcat config. So you'll be having a file called context file. See, open this file in notepad format, like open with the notepad format. See, here you'll be finding that URL format, but small changes. Okay, here on top of owner is PostGRE we have taken, right? So up to here JDBC URL structure is common, but what it is in the real time is what is that URL you will be getting the URL information, but here in the personal edition right now, so up to here it is same, but the database name we have given is different, right? ABCDB, so that we have to configure. But up to here in your application, so what is the JDBC format is there, so use the same format, but last name we have to change to, so slash we have to give, in my system it is ABCDB, so that I need to update here. Okay, sometimes in your systems the port number can be different, so don't copy the same. Check in your application under this folder and open that file and check accordingly, because it can be different in your system. Sometimes it can be 5433 or some other port number can be there, so check it accordingly. Then in your system, what is the database name you provided, so give that name, don't give the same what I have given here. Then other thing is, here you have to configure actually owner and everything on top of the same we have given, right? So username and password we have to assign. So username is PostGRS and password is also PostGRS, but in the real time it can be different. If you're using some other database in the real time, it can be different in the real time. So as of now, so provide PostGRS and password is also PostGRS. So save this, click on save. Now we can verify this connection is successful, that is successfully connected or not. If you want to verify, click on test connection button. So if it is showing the status as good and successfully connected to database ABCDB, means it is completed. Okay, now after the database connection, we need to create a data type in this application. So in order to communicate the physical table with PEGA tables, so we need to create one data type in this platform. So add a new data type with same column names, and source also we have to set here, and you can create a division level also, you can create, no issue. So add a new data type, you can give some name. And I'm creating a division level directly. So directly you can click on submit. So the fourth step we are creating is create a data class. Actually it is data type. So create a data type and properties to map to the above table. Data type and properties. And also add source. See, source is nothing but we are going to define the key. Okay, so compulsory key also we need to define. So after adding the fields, so source also we need to define. So basically customer ID will be setting, customer ID is set as a source in the external table, and here also we'll be setting customer ID as the source here. Now other one is go to records, configure source. But we don't records, we don't directly enter records, we have to load, right? There is a rule called database table rule. So using the table rule, we are going to communicate with the external table. So after creating this data type, just configure the source and sub. So click on close. Now again, next step is one more sysadmin rule we need to configure, that is database table is the other rule we need to configure. Okay, you can close the table now. Again, go to App Explorer under sysadmin category. The next step is create a connection to data type and data table. Okay, so that is the step number 5. For class and table mapping, create a rule called database table rule. So the next step is from sysadmin category. But actually, when you try to define this table, we need to give the description like this one, and class name will be providing your C table just now, which is created. You may not get in the down arrow. Maybe type it, or if you see here C table name, if you want to copy paste, means manually open from class explorer and you can copy paste. Okay, see here, but when you try to open this rule by default in the application with the same label, some default class is there, worklayer class is there when you try to open this. See, anyone when you try to open after giving the details, you'll be getting instance exists. Okay, so instance already exists, you'll be getting, because the reason is actually with the same label in the backend, in the application already, your worklayer label and this one is also same, it is matching. So what we need to do means, when you try to open, if you get this instance exist, what I can do means go to records tab, go to records tab, sysadmin category, go to database table, open database table rule, and here you'll be getting this starting one which I try to open. So C table with that name, one table will be, database table will be created. So open this one, the first one you have to open. So there directly directly you can update the details. See, database name is in my application abcdb, and the table name and all in the external table, what is the name given, so give that. In application I have given in lower case, in the external table, so give the table name. So you don't get in the drop down, so remember and make sure, or you can verify in the rule base and give it here. So in my system I have given like this. Okay, so customer table in lowercase, completely lowercase I have given. So then just to give these two, report database also if you want you can give, not mandatory. Database and report database will be same, and provide the table name as a customer table. Now click on save. Now check the connectivity. So these also you can verify the connectivity. So it will show the, see, warning, no issue. So it will show is mapped to the table public dot customer table in the ABCDB. So it is connected to the external table. So the next step is, now see, in order to communicate with the data records, if you want to fetch the records from the external tables, so we'll be using some rule called connect SQL rule. Okay, so go to App Explorer. And coming to this connect SQL rules, we need to define in the table class we have to define. So that is open that data-c table. So the next step is, in order to fetch the data, so we need to create a connect SQL rule and write the queries. Actually not queries here, write required statements. Okay, so we need to write some statements here. Okay, so like a basic class and property statements only. So this particular statements we need to define in the, that is in order to open that connect SQL, so we need to open from the table class, we need to open, not from the work layer. So always connect SQL. See, earlier if you fetch any data from any report definition or data page where we are creating, in the same table class we are creating the report definition or data page. Similarly, if you are fetching any data from any external table also, so the reference table for mapping we have to use is this one. So under this only we need to define the connect SQL. So right click on this, go to integration, connectors. So use control minus if you are unable to see all the names. Actually, in the integration connectors, you'll be having one rule name. If you are unable to see, use control minus. You can click on connect SQL. Now here I need to fill the parameters. Some details we can provide. So you can give some name. I'm giving as get customers. Applies to means, see your table name again. So applies to is nothing but, so it is not showing in the drop down. So what we can do means, you can just type copy paste it manually. Then package name, you can give something as SQL. Okay, so after filling the details, so click on open. See, when you open this, you'll be getting, so four tabs you'll be getting: open, delete, save, and browse. Okay, see what kind of mostly will be performing, browser open action will be performing. So mostly when you have any data, save action we don't perform much, or delete also we don't perform much. Mostly fetching single or fetching multiple records will perform. See what kind of action we perform, accordingly we need to write the query in the particular tab. See, in the previous classes, internal database when working, we have these obj open, obj delete, obj save, obj browse are there, right? Similarly, when communicating with any external tables, so we'll be using some methods called RDB methods. So same tabs will be getting same functionality, but here we have to write the statements here. Okay, so for this, don't worry, no need to have a complete knowledge on SQL. Suppose if you don't have any knowledge, some team will be there, they are going to help you. Okay, so here some basic statements we have to define, like what kind of action we are going to perform on the table. So which action you perform, so in that particular tab we need to write the statement. So if you perform fetching single record means, in open tab we need to write the statement. In fetching multiple records if you are performing, so we need to write it in the browse tab. See, for that the statements are very simple guys. For that, no need to have any complete SQL knowledge, anybody can write that. Just the format will be very simple, so I'll show you that format. See here, open button is to fetch single record, delete maximum we don't use, save is to save or insert. Insert or update, both we can update in the, to insert or update. So to insert or update, we'll add it in the save option, and to fetch multiple records, we'll add it in the browse option. Okay, and now generally the statement is very simple. Select star from your table class. Okay, so class colon, so you have to mention your table class name. Suppose in your system, if you give the same names, same organization, same division names are there, so then you can directly copy paste this. But if you have a different organization or division names, means accordingly, so type it manually in your application. So I'm writing the statement here, select star from class colon, so your table name. So actually this is a mapping table, so mapping name and all we created physically, right? So the mapping name is this one. So by using database table rule, mapping is done, right? So anywhere mapping if you're doing, means physical table name we have to use this one. Okay, but external table is different. So but physical mapping when you are doing, so we have to use this as a table name. Like that in open, if you want to adapt, if you want to write anything in the open, so just where condition we have to define, same thing, but which one you are going to fetch. So where, so see customer ID equal to, so customer ID is equal to, suppose any single record if you want to fetch, in double quotes you can give C1 something like this. So like that, any conditions if you are going to define, so we have to define like that. But one thing is here, whenever we are going to give these parameters, so everything is case sensitive. Okay, suppose where and all, you have to give it in lowercase only. So make sure all the parameters are case sensitive. S also you have to give in uppercase, like F also give it in uppercase, colon you have to give. So like that, apply the condition. So what kind of action you perform on the tab, we are going to perform this, we are going to add the statements. And in order to read these statements in application, we need to create an activity. So I suppose I'm going to perform this action now. So in order to perform this fetching multiple records action, so we need to create an activity, and in that we'll be using RDB methods. See, if it is internal database means we'll be using OBJ methods. If it is a external database means we need to use RDB methods. Same way how we have four OBJ methods are there, so four RDB methods are there. So RDB open, delete means RDB delete, save means RDB save, and browse means RDB list is the method name. Okay, OBJ browse is the name of method for internal database, but OBJ browse is nothing but in the browse tab if you write any query, the method name is RDB list is the method name. Okay, so these four methods you will be having. So now any action if you want to perform or which statement you are going to read now, so accordingly we'll be having these methods. So RDB open, save, list and delete. Okay, so now we are going to read the statement from the browse tab. So we are going to use this method now. Okay? But activity now where we need to define means inside the work layer you have to define. Again go back to work layer, open activity. And other thing I want to tell you, see, when you fetch any data from external databases also, initially the data will map to clipboard page. See guys, other thing is anything internal database if you load or external database if you load also, initially we have a primary server or interface is clipboard. So if you load any records also now, even from external tables also, it will first of all load to the clipboard. Again from the clipboard, how to map to the UI, we know, same process. So first of all, create this activity. So open this activity. See how OBJ browse we use same only, but maybe one two parameters will be different here. So no need to define any patient classes, directly we can use RDB list also. And RDB list structure also same, like how OBJ browse structure will be created in clipboard. Same way RDB list when you are using also, same mapping we have to do in the from clipboard page to UI page, how we used to map it in the earlier classes when using OBJ browse. Same configuration and same structure will be created for RDB list also. Okay, now let's see. So expand this one now. Excuse me. So request type is SQL I'm using. So access name, see here, sorry guys, request type is nothing but your connect SQL rule name what is given. So that is request type. I have given as get customers, right? Use the request type as get customers. You don't get in the drop down. Access is nothing but package name. See, package name I have given as SQL. See, if you place the pointer on that SQL name, you'll get as package name. So package name is nothing but SQL. So in your system what you have given, provide that. And class name is your table, mapping table name is there, right? So alpha-data-c table. And we have to use the browse page. Actually in the clipboard one user page will be created, right? So give some page name, and under this page the results will be loaded in the clipboard. Okay, so I'm giving some page here. So if you see activity, so fill these parameters. Okay, here I have given C page, whatever you can give anything. Okay, I'll give C page only, again you'll get confused. Okay, I'm giving some page name, and what are the page name we have given here? Under this page the records will load to the clipboard. Okay, so save it and run the activity, and run this activity and debug using clipboard tool. So run this activity and debug using clipboard. So go to actions and run. So click on this run option and click on clipboard. See, in my external table what are the records are there, now we can check it under the user page now. And for OBJ browse, what is the structure? Like a user page will be sent to code-pegf list. Under that you will be having px results, and under the px results we can find the list of results. So same structure will be created here again. C page will refer to this list class. Expand that you'll be having px results, and expand px results, how many records are there, the number of index will be created, and open each one, you can see the results. Okay, so like that process is same. Okay, again, I think we know, right, from clipboard page to the UI page how to load the results. So this is the user page in which UI design you are going to map the data. So this page we have to copy and give it in the page name, and this is the class name we have to specify in the class option. Under page and classes, you'll define this class and page name, and under the source option you have to configure the, using list source we can configure as a clipboard page, and we have to fill the parameters. Same example for state property, how I did in the earlier classes when fetching multiple records from the internal table, same way the structure is created here, and this data we have to, wherever in your application requirement is there, so there we need to map these results. Okay, so up to here just it is okay. So up to here you can just do. Later if you want to do this mapping for any property, you can do from here, you can do it in your own. Okay, because earlier we know, right, how to map the data from clipboard to the UI page, same way you can map. Okay, so that is how any other action you want to perform also in the same connect SQL rule. So any other action you want to perform, so based on that, which statement you are going to define or which action you are going to define. So if it is open means RDB open we have to use. So any save action you want to perform, we need to write it in the save option. Don't worry if you don't have any knowledge on these statements and all. So in the real time, every who has knowledge on these statements and all, so to them the work will be assigned. Okay, so that is about this communicating with any, see, internal databases when you are communicating, so we'll be using these OBJ methods, and any external databases if you are communicating, so we'll be using RDB methods we have to use. Okay, so that is about the communication between application and any external database. Maybe the first two steps names can be different in the real time, but process is same. Okay, remaining steps and all in the PRPC platform, what are the steps we configured, and first two steps also maybe the owner name can be different, but procedure is common. Okay, so that's